armored personnel carriers, and maybe even tanks that have the church's mountain neighbors worried and wondering.
Is there an arsenal of weapons?
Absolutely not. There is no arsenal. This is Montana. Some of our staff members here own hunting rifles just like everybody else, and they'll go out and get an elk. The church does not own weapons, does not stockpile weapons. I can tell you I've known Mrs. Prophet personally and deeply for 20 years. She would never allow this church to have a stockpile of weapons, to become an armed camp or anything like that.
Well, there's been a sense of betrayal and lack of trust.
Newspaper publisher John Sullivan has kept the church under a microscope and warns danger may be waiting.
We have a religious-based organization with private property, with, in this case, large bomb shelters, underground shelters stocked with provisions and supplies for up to 7 years. We have the church leadership that's been involved in illegal weapons purchases and very convincing evidence in my mind that there is a lot larger arsenal of weapons than was ever involved in even the illegal, the prosecution of the illegal activities.
It's about the same as getting your ear pierced.
Ah! It's okay. It makes a big deal out of it.
Instant earring.
The church members deny any illegal activity on their ranch and say it's nothing more than a close-knit community, complete with general store and restaurant.
Well, I think it's a prototype city. You know, we have a mail department. You know, we have our own post office. We have firemen. We have a good, solid medical staff. You know, we run an ambulance. And we have our schools. So if you take a look at that, you have the makings of a good, small community and where we live with lots of people who have the same values and same lifestyle.
Still, cult expert Rick Ross calls this isolationism. He says ex-members talk about it, and he says it's typical of cults.
I don't think that there's any reason to conclude that Church Universal is moving in a direction of being mainstream. In fact, what they are doing is moving in the direction of becoming more and more isolated, witnessed by the communities around them, their neighbors, and ex-members who are coming out and telling some pretty bad stories about what life was like in Church Universal and Triumphant.
And when protected fully by the Holy Spirit, He will illumine us as He promised He would do. He promised that He would come to us, that the Comforter would come, the Holy Spirit, and bring all those things to our remembrance which He had originally taught to us.
Newspaper man Sullivan says it's not the church's religious practice alone that bothers him. It's what he and others in Montana believe may be hidden behind their faith.
They are not to be trusted. They are a cult. Any cult is dangerous. They are a means to an end organization.
We're people just like everyone else who are looking for, I mean, just looking for a better way of life, a more profound way of life. We're not violent. We love people. We love life. We love experiencing different kinds of things. And we're diverse. I mean, you've got the whole gamut, the whole cross-section of the world right here.
The issue is not whether or not they're nice people, but where are they being led by a person like Elizabeth Clare Prophet, who claims to not only speak for Jesus, but Buddha too. And she is an absolute authoritarian leader that exercises total control over her followers.
We are a wonderful example of trying to make a New Age religion work.
Cult or church, Elizabeth Clare Prophet has the last word.
I don't consider myself a cult because I am not dominating my members. I lead my people to the heart of the I Am that I Am, who appeared to Moses, the individualized presence of God that we commune with. People who believe one way in this country do not give the freedom to others to believe in another way. We have worked very hard on racial bigotry in this country, but we have not worked hard on religious persecution.
Sean Rabb, News for Texas, Sunrise.